2008, I heard the gym back then called Soul Power was up for sale. So I come down, had a look around the gym, and basically just took the initiative from there on and just bought the gym. So it was pretty, from a business perspective, it was a good deal. I think the amateurs was about a year after we had, we bought the gym. Basically what happened was, from a club perspective, so many young kids coming into the gym just to train. Like, I think I remember one time we used to do kids' birthday parties here. We were doing like having like 20, 30 kids in here and that. And I remember we were speaking to a gentleman over in Welling called Tony Fuller, who's passed away since. And I spoke to him and another gentleman called Richard Sawyer. And basically what we done was we sat down, had a meeting and stuff, put all the plans and that together towards the ABA of London. And basically I think Body Shots ABC was founded in 2009, and I think in that first year we had a kid go to the Europeans and win a silver. We had, I think it was 7 or 8 London champions that year, national champion that year, and I think we had a good first season there, so I don't think we haven't done nothing since the record set. Good as what we've done in the first year. We do so much for the community as well. I mean, we take kids off the streets, we change people's lives. It's kind of like, so that kind of tool and mindset is what we want to kind of keep progressing and stuff. Basically, like I said, the reason why we started the club and the amateurs was because obviously it was to build a legacy. And we always said, like, when Tony Fuller passed away, that was the kind of mindset that we wanted to stay with the club. It's about a legacy. I mean, if you look, the Repton's been going around for years, the Lynn's been around. I think the Lynn's one of the oldest clubs in the amateur scene and stuff. So for us to be where we're at in 6 years, to achieve what we've done in 6 years, some amateur clubs have taken them a whole lifetime. So I think for us, I mean, in 50 years' time, we'll probably be known as a very, very, very strong club. Mm. I'll probably be nearly dead. or dead. Do you know, like, but like I said, the club is not just about a person. The club's about a legacy. So that's why I see it in 50 years' time is obviously being around for a very, very, very long time.
50 years is a long, long way off, isn't it? You know, there's a lot of clubs don't last 5 years, let alone 50. But that's down to the people that help run it.